Hi there everyone and welcome back to another lesson. This video is really going to help you out in order to learn how we can use ChatGPT to create such formulas, such macros, VBAs, and Excel formulas which help us use Excel efficiently. So first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to find out the difference between these two things, which are macros and VBA differences. Now, it's very important that before using any particular function on anything in Excel, you get to know that what each word or terminology means. So once I Google it, you're going to see that ChatGPT is going to give me exact definition of what a macro is and what's a VBA. So right here, a macro is basically a sequence of instruction that automates tasks in software applications. In this case, we're using it particularly for Excel. And VBA is basically Visual Basics for Application. It's basically a programming language developed in Microsoft that is built into most Microsoft Office applications, and one of them is going to be Excel. Right here, I'm going to show you a scenario in which I have three different problems and I need to get through them in order to create some VBAs or macros or Excel formula, whatever is necessary. Right now, my very first question that I would like to ask Mr. ChatGPT is going to be a scenario in which I have to separate my first and last name. Now, you do not have to struggle looking for a formula or generating one on your own in Excel. You can simply give it a prompt. Let's say, I want to separate first and the last name in Excel sheet, please generate a formula for Excel for me. Now, once I give a go to this message, I'm going to see how magically it's going to create different formulas, not even one. So it gives you a lot of leverage on using different sort of functions you have. In this case, it told us that if you have a full name in a single cell and you want to separate the first and last name, then you can use a combination of text functions. Now you particularly know where to look at. So here it has given us a left and a right function. So we can use them simply. You just have to copy the formula from here, go back, select your data and add it up there. Now we're going to look at a specific situation where we will use a certain macro in order to find out how we can create a certain set of instructions which help us resolve problems. So I would say create a macro for me for sifting out the duplicates from an Excel sheet and putting them in a separate sheet. Now, what I want is I want to create a macro for sifting out the duplicates. Let's say I have a lot of data which has duplicate names, duplicate dates, but I want them to be sifted out. I only want that particular data which is required, which is non-duplicated, which has different values and different names only. And I want to exactly know that who is that sort of employee or the person who is actually resulting in duplicates, so I can use a simple macro. Now it's going to generate the macro for us right here. And this macro has to be added into the code for that particular sheet. Let's see how to do that. The most amazing thing about ChatGPT is that it actually gives you instructions about how to run. For example, it says here below is a simple VBA macro. We already know what is VBA from the top. VBA stands for Visual Basics for Applications. So it's a programming language we're using right now to create some automated system which will not have us doing a lot of hard work on our own. So here we have the simple VBA code that we simply have to copy from here and we have to paste and run it. But before that, you can see ChatGPT has given us particular instructions. For example, it says to make sure to back up your Excel files so that they are not deleted. The next step, it says that you have to open the Excel file and press Alt F11 to open up the Visual Basics for application. Now, these instructions are really important, and if they're not paid heed to, you're going to get reference invalid or any sort of error that is probably going to come if you are not going to put the VBA code at the right place. And if there are some extra spaces, it's going to cause problems. So this is how you can use Mr. ChatGPT to simply produce your code. You're going to copy it, you're going to add it. There are many videos and there is a lot of data that you can use from YouTube and other things as well, how to generate these codes. But there is a lot of margin of error because you are copy-pasting stuff. You are typing things manually yourself too. So ChatGPT simply gives you one click away copied VBA codes, which you can add, and you can simply use them in order to create simple running programs in Microsoft Excel. I hope this video proved helpful. There is a lot more you can do with Excel depending upon your novel situation, your novel problem, or the type of data you have. And I am hopeful that this video would help you out, get out of these problems really easily and quickly. Thank you very much.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.